Okay, because YouTube got this thing where, like, when I try to upload a video, it don't upload unless I'm in YouTube. And that means I got to be in YouTube for, like, a good 5 hours. Bro, I'm not doing that. Like, I just can't. So I was about to wait until the graduation vlog uploaded. I was about to do 2 intros, like, for today's vlog, which is the A Boogie Castle. Y'all, first of all, I'm a fake A Boogie fan. I am a fake A Boogie fan. Like, I listen to A Boogie occasionally. Like, I got a good 6 songs on rap, but I don't know all of them. But I feel like this is like going to a concert where you know some songs of the artist but you don't know all of them. I feel like that's good, because then once you see how they can perform it, then you feel the vibe, and then you'd be like, damn, I'm putting that shit on my playlist when I get home. Because I know, like, Come Closer, Did Me Wrong, Drowning, I know Good Girls Gone Bad, like, I know some of the biddies, but I don't know all of them. And I'm not mad at it. Like, I'm not mad to admit that I don't really listen to A Boogie. I'm going for the vibes, nothing wrong with that. And if I fuck with some of the songs, then I'm gonna come home and put that shit on my playlist. Like, it's okay. So today is Tuesday. He's coming to Philly Tuesday, June 18th, 8 p.m. I don't know what time my sister's getting here, because I can't even text her. For some reason, I just woke up to the message talking about some, your iCloud device, Apple ID device is unable to link your phone. You can't receive messages or something. Some bullshit ass excuse. Not excuse, but it's just like, they're not letting me sign in my Apple ID so I can receive messages. Are you fucking serious? It's always something with iPhones. Like, it's always something with Apple. I can't deal with it. I can't. But yesterday, I went to work. I worked all weekend. Like, I'm tired. This is about to be my rejuvenation, like, get my hype back. And then this weekend, I'm going to AC. That's the second intro that I have to do. But I'm going to wait until, like, I need to start waiting until a video is done before I actually start filming the other one, because then I be getting everything mixed up. I don't be having storage for everything. So yeah, one thing at a time, guys. But literally, like, this is gonna be such a relaxing week. Like, I'm just excited. So right now I'm chilling. My sister coming from Jersey. I don't know when she's leaving. Like I said, I can't text her. I probably just gotta call her, but I hate being on the phone. Anyway, I'm gonna get in the shower around, like, I don't even know, because we leaving, it started at 8, we leaving around like 5:30. My sister wanna go eat, but I don't have money. Like, I literally don't have money. Like, I'm going to AC this weekend, I only have $50 fucking to my name. Hopefully that changes. But she wanna go eat, but I wanna get there early, because I missed the last Phillies Sixers game. I said two different sports. I literally missed the last Sixers game in Philly because we literally left the house an hour and a half. And by the time, it was literally second quarter and we still didn't make it in the building. It was just traffic. I was so distraught. I was, and then the main thing is, like, I think we went to the playoffs. I don't really remember. So then the money for the tickets went up. So we couldn't even go see the game since we missed the last one. And I'm so pissed. Like, that was like my last game before I go off to college. Because also another thing, I'm moving to Norfolk August 10th. So I gotta start dorm shopping too. It's a whole bunch of shit going on. I low-key need to give y'all a spiel, but one thing at a time. So I'm gonna just keep laying down until my sister come. Yesterday, I went to go see Inside Out. First of all, put in the comments down below how y'all feel about Inside Out 2. It wasn't what everybody was raving about. For real. Like, y'all know how Inside Out 1, sadness pissed you off the whole movie. Inside Out 2, anxiety pissed me off the whole movie. So that's probably why I'm not really feeling it, for real. But all I know is that I went to go with my friends, and it was a cute little vibe. I think somebody's in the house. It was a cute little vibe. Because, like, something finally made it at the group chat. Like, I be planning for things with my friends. It never happens. Like, it never sees the light of day. So I was so happy for that to fall through, especially like my work, like my coworkers. Like, I don't consider them coworkers. I consider them real genuine close friends. So, like, the fact we finally got outside of the job to hang out for once, I was happy for it. So yesterday after the movies, me and my friend went to Barnes & Noble's because while I was waiting for them to come, I went in Barnes & Noble's just for laughs and giggles because I wasn't, like, trying to wait in the mall. So I just went in there. And then I saw a bunch of books. First of all, I am a firm believer that you guys have to read the books before you watch the series or the movie or anything, because it will be chef's kiss 10 times out of 10 better. You can actually know what to expect. And sometimes what do be pissing me off is the shit that be in the books don't be in the movie or the series, but it's fine. So I'm doing that with Bridgerton because, first of all, I don't care about season 3. The only thing I care about in season 3 is Francesca and Eloise, because Penelope got off too fucking easy. It's like, I didn't even watch it. I know everything that happens based off of TikTok. I don't know why it spoiled it for me, but you know, it was my fault too. I didn't scroll. All I know is that Penelope, you got off too easy. Philippa ate, left no crumbs. She's so adorable. She's a baddie. She's been a baddie, period. And then I just know that, never mind, because that's going to spoil it for the people that ain't watch it. But if they mess up Francesca's love life, I will stop watching that show. Like, I already want to stop watching it because they let Penelope get off. So if they fuck up Francesca's shit, you're not. I was supposed to be reading this book series. I've been seeing this literally all over TikTok. But this is about dragons. And respectfully, I'm not in the mood to read about dragons right now. But, like, dragons and wolves and beasts. Yeah. And it's a 5-book series. I'ma just wait it. I'ma just hold off on it for a little bit. So, yesterday, my little bookmark with my friends. I have that one, and I have this one from me and Vic last year. I'ma put that up. I'ma put both of them up. But I got 3 Bridgerton books, and I'm not mad at it. First of all, they were all $9 and $10 each. This hefty ass book for $9, steal. And then I also got my sister some books, but she's not getting them until I leave for AC, because she'll be the type of person to ignore me. Like, I don't know how to explain it. Like, yesterday I came home and I was gonna surprise her with the books, but she came home talking about something. I was ugly. So I'm gonna keep your ugly ass books in my ugly ass storage until I leave. Until my ugly ass leaves. So, first one that I got, Eloise. Penelope ruined Theo and Eloise. So, I don't know what to expect with this book. I just know I screamed when I saw all 3 of these books. So, this is Eloise's story. Sir Philip, I don't even know who that is. I know he was in the show. I don't even know who that is, though. Then we got Hyacinth, the younger sister. Isn't she, like, 12? Like, how does she get a love life already? I'm not mad at it. But, excited for this one. And then lastly, like I said, Francesca's. Like, I think I might just have to read this now, because I don't know what's happening in the series. I don't know what they're trying to do. I saw what they're trying to do and I don't like it. When they say the unexpected plot twist, that was unexpected plot twist. That better not happen. That better not happen. This dark spot from yesterday had the big ass pimple. Everything, like, as soon as I have an event, dark spot. Literally the one for my graduation, it was there, brightest, like, darkest shit on my graduation. Now it's not there. A Boogie concert, now it's here. Like, just can't have nothing. But oh child, my heart was in my ass real quick with that sentence. I'm gonna start reading this. These are mainly for, my thing is like, if it makes me happy, I'm gonna buy it, whether I'm gonna be broke at the end or not. So I just saw all of these and I was like, I'm just gonna grab them. I mainly got these because I'm going to AC and we're gonna be on the beach and I want to read a book while tanning. The fuck? So, yes. Got this. And I'm gonna start it today. I'm gonna wait for my video to upload. I really wanted to upload. Here's all the Bridgerton books in there. I didn't get the Duke and I because I saw that. I didn't get Kat and Anthony. I should get it just to have it on my bookshelf because that was the best season. Like, okay, that was the best love story. Even though I don't like how they did Edwina. And they definitely made Kate. Okay, if y'all didn't watch it, just skip a little bit, but they definitely made Kate like have to like go into a coma and shit so that way she can get off. Like Edwina will be like, oh my god, my sister's hurt, like I don't see anything else but my sister being healthy. Like they did that on purpose because there wasn't any other way that Kate could really make up to Edwina, so they did that. And then that's why everybody's like, oh, Cantony is so cute. I still believe that she should have just been told the sister she wanted the man. I love Kate and Anthony, but you did your sister wrong. Like, if that was my sister after the coma, I'll beat her ass. But Benedict's love story, I have to get. And then they have Gregory. So first of all, Gregory is young as shit. And everybody's on TikTok talking about he's the net, like, the freakiest one. So after I finish these three, I'm gonna go get those. And then apparently they have Happily Ever After the Bridgertons, which is Violet's love story. And y'all know we need Violet and Edmund's love story, like, exact. So, yeah. I'm gonna get those. And then they have, like, prequels, but I don't believe in prequels because what the fuck else are you trying to do? With Julia Quinn, come on. Just keep it in the family. But hopefully by the time I start reading these books, my video is uploaded so I can stop rambling. But I'm gonna just see y'all when I actually get up, get ready. I have to wash my face. I have to take a shower because last night, like, I was beat. But I just went to bed. So I have to take a shower, do my skincare, do my edges. And I already have my outfit. I gotta switch out my jewelry and shit because I'm going gold. I'm going gold. And I don't know. Well, I mean, it goes with the outfit. But, like, I don't know how to feel about it because I be mixing metals. But, like, this time, I like, gold earrings, gold bracelets only. But I'm gonna see y'all when I actually, I'm gonna see y'all when my sister texts me so I can give y'all an update. Actually, jump scare, just letting y'all know. I always put this face mask on. This is probably one of my favorite face masks, but I'm about to try this Fruity Pebble and Lucky Charms cereal. First of all, y'all know I don't eat cereal because cereal hurts my stomach, but it's something I'm gonna try. It's not bad, but from that little ass bite, my stomach actually hurt. I know my ass, I will not finish this bowl.
Oh yeah, the stuff on my face is from the face mask,
but I'm about to eat some fish sticks and mac and cheese. Oh my god, I'm so freaking tired. Like, I went to bed at 1 in the morning because I was editing the graduation vlog, and it uploaded, period. All uploaded. That was the fastest I probably edited, like, because I can edit within a day, but, like, it was all, why is this falling? Because I can edit throughout, like, a whole day, but I edited that whole vlog from 1 hour and 25 minutes to 35, and I did that from, like, 10 to 1. That was actually the fastest I've ever edited a vlog. And exported it in one day, because after that I literally just exported, and I woke up to the notification that said your movie has been exported. So I'm just tired. So I'm about to just go eat real quick, watch this baddies episode, and then I'm gonna lay down. I'm gonna wake up at like 3 o'clock to take a shower because it don't really take me that long to get ready. I just want to have spare time. So today is a prime example of why I cannot wait until August 10th, because I don't know. I feel like just the person I am, I'm Mrs. Make It Happen, and nothing happens here. So if I don't do it myself, then nothing really will happen. So I can't wait to, like, be on campus. And if I be like, I want Chick-fil-A, walk on campus. I want Starbucks, walk on campus. I want Smoothie King, walk on campus. Like, instead of waiting around for a fucking ride or somebody not having no money. Like, it's always bullshit excuses. Whatever. I'm about to just try and read chapter 1 of this book because I'm tired of TikTok And then I'm getting in the shower at 5 because my sister still hasn't left yet.
It's fucking hot. One thing that pisses me off is like not having energy before going to an event. And I literally need like a pink drink or like a smoothie, something. And nobody's comprehending that shit. So I'm probably gonna have a funky attitude the whole fucking day. Because I'm not like, I just, as healthy as it may sound, or unhealthy, as healthy as it may be, but unhealthy as it sounds, I can't just drink water all fucking day. I'm sorry, I can't. This hair used to be so soft, now it's all like ragdoll-y. About to wash my face because I didn't wash it from earlier, and then actually get in the shower.
So now my sister's ETA changed. And she was supposed to be here at 6:15. Now she's gonna be here at 6:24. So I'm about to get in the shower.
I wish I had my lip combo, but I don't have it. So I'm gonna have to see what else I have. But I'm gonna get in the shower. I didn't even show you the outfit. This was my old lip combo, clearly. So I always do a brown and a color instead of a brown and a clear. I never did a brown and a clear. Maybe I should try it out, but not today. I'm not chasing anything. So this is the combo. But I'm gonna put this on because after I get in the shower, I'm eating. So yeah, this Ed Hardy shirt. Y'all know Ed Hardy on the Ed. I'm good for Ed Hardy. So it's like this. And then on the back is gold. And I got some red biker shorts because it's 92 degrees in Philly right now. And then I got these little like socks off of Shein. They're like frilled on the side because I'm wearing my Sambas.
Okay, so this is what it looks like before like the lip combo. Y'all can't even see me because I'm short. Before the lip combo and everything. I want the blonde to show. Or like the brown, and like my right part is the only side that really has it, but like my right part don't look right, no pun intended. Wait, never mind, I think this might be fine. I'm about to this is this. So I want some of this blonde to show. But like she got all the blonde in the back. I think I might just do it like this. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do a right part because I don't really do right parts. So I'm about to put some oil sheen in my hair, in my head, because my hair is dry and shit. And it's already getting fuzzy. I hate that shit. I picked out some sunglasses. I feel like this outfit might need some sunglasses. Like, it's already cute. I feel like I just need to see the edges. I might take the pics like this. I wrote this song because I have the back of the shirt to show. For sure. Ugh, my neck's making me feel claustrophobic. I'm about to... My mom said dinner is supposed to be like... She got Popeyes. Where is it at? And I need to pick out a fragrance too. I don't know what perfume I'm wearing. Because one thing I always hate is like whenever I go out and you can smell the perfume wearing off. Like when you're sweaty and you smell the sweat mixed with the perfume. No, ma'am. I don't like that. Y'all want an affordable perfume? This Jimmy Choo I Want You smells just like this. So does this Chanel number 5. Not the one that Priscilla of this had. Like. Number 5. So I'm gonna spray this and then I'm gonna thicken it up with this. All right.
I'm gonna see y'all when I've done my edges. The amount of times I have to wash this fucking edge brush pisses me off. I look like I'm going to a picnic. I need to go to the hair store ASAP, Milwaukee. I'm almost out of gel. And I need a new edge brush because that shit is crusty, musty, dusty. Yo, I don't know what's going on with my braids, but I'm about to put my jewelry on. So these drawings Kyla gave to me for my birthday. And then the red I got from the crystal bracelet store. I gotta figure out how the fuck to do this shit. All right, my sister here, this is how the edges turned out. I like the right side, but definitely only for pictures because it's already getting cool on my bracelets and shit. I'm not rushing. Like, I'm rushing because of traffic and traffic only, baby. All right, almost done. Got two more things to do.
All right.
Gotta leave the brows nice, wispy. That's cute. Let me get the lip pop off. We done
it,
we out.
Alrighty. We're going to the court now. A Boogie concert, y'all already know.
Make a right, right?
No, make a left, India. That's an illegal right.
I mean, y'all be seeing people do it.
Okay, but we don't do illegal things on this side. I'm debating, like, for pictures, do I keep the sunglasses on or do I take them off? Well, I'm gonna do both.
I mean, I thought you was wearing a whole different outfit.
But I literally showed you this.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I
did. Messages. It's not there.
No, I showed you in person. Oh. But your bun is cute. You're wearing a little dirt shirt to a Boogie concert.
Oh, I have my other shirt in here.
I was about to say.
And it's see-through, that's why.
Oh.
Yeah. Gotta play smart.
Work smarter, not harder. Already came off. Are you taking pictures? You think I should take my pictures before the concert? Because after or during gonna be too much.
During is gonna be too much.
In 3/4 of a mile, turn left.
Y'all tell me how we was literally right at the Wells Fargo Center, but Siri told us to do an illegal U-turn. And actually, I would have told you to do the illegal U-turn, but the cop was literally right in our fucking face. That's why I said I didn't do it. Why the fuck? So we go straight to go like in another lane so we can try and make a U-turn. Why the fuck is taking us to the airport? So now we gotta, it's an additional 14 minutes. We was about to be there at 7:25. Now our ETA is 7:20 or 7:40. And then we saw people selling t-shirts already. But
it doesn't matter because he's not coming out until like 9 o'clock.
That's true. So I'm about to get my pictures as soon as we go in there. And I think last time we was here because it was basketball season, but they had arenas.
Right,
so I'm going to get arenas
Avenue,
because I need something.
West.
Because they got chicken pizza shit, but I'm not spending my money on chicken pizza. All right, I'm about to put the lip combo back on because after we go in, we just gonna take these pictures and shit my ass.
So where's the Wells Fargo? This up?
Yeah. All right, so you walking up the stairs right there. Huh? Yeah. So we right here. I didn't know we was gonna be this close. Like, the nigga really will be right there.
And then zoom in, you know, like the zoom in wise.
There he is.
All these bitches is my sons. And I'ma go and get some dicks for them. A couple formulas, little pretty lips on them.
If I had a dick, I would pull it out and
Federal Donuts Philly chicken sandwich is set is at $12. Yeah, nah, babe. To get. Yeah, no. I'm just getting my regular joint. Fuck it.
Are you getting a Hokey
stuff? I might. Let me look. Get a kid's hoagie. Oh, they got grilled cheese. Should I get it? Grilled cheese. And yeah, I don't want none of that shit. I'm gonna try. I'll take it. I get a snack. You want one of these? Any of these? I don't want any of them. Big back shit.
All right, y'all, we're home. I had a blast. I'm actually sad I didn't get pictures, but y'all know I'm good to spin it off and back. So it's literally 1 a.m. I've been home later than this before, but shit, I better get used to it. College life starts soon. I low-key ate on my edges though. I'm not getting dressed up again until this weekend. But got my 2 shirts. I'm gonna wear them probably tomorrow. But I'm about to literally change and go back. Like, I'll take the shower tomorrow morning.
Okay, it is the next day after the A Boogie concert. You can hear my voice. I enjoyed myself mentally. I'm still at the fucking concert. I had a ball. I'm telling you, left at 11, didn't get home till like 1. Oh my god, if I could go back, look back at it. She ain't never do this before, but she good at it. So she never made love, but she good at it. She make a nigga feel good when I look at it. I get goosebumps when I look at it. Girl, just wanna have fun with it. Girl, just wanna have fun with me. These girls ain't really no good for me. Y'all, so impulsive. Okay, actually no, they weren't really. This one was the one that I wanted. I literally, so one thing about concerts is that inside the motherfucking concert, this shit was expensive. Like the shirt that I really wanted, it's like the gray A Boogie shirt and it has like green outline on it. I wanted that shit so bad, but not for 45. Not for 45, baby girl. Who has that money? Not me. So, literally, if y'all don't know, if y'all want to save yourself a coin, they be like, I'm not going to say the bootleg sellers be out, but the affordable sellers be out after the concert. So, before the concert, my sister got that shirt, which I'm about to show y'all, and she got it for 20 or 25, one of them. And I wanted a I didn't actually want a shirt, but I wanted a shirt after the fact because y'all know that I came into the concert not knowing. Like, I knew, like, out of his whole set list, I knew about like 8 or 9 songs. I didn't know all of them. But leaving the concert, I'm a motherfucking A Boogie artist, whatever the fuck he calls his fans, artists, whatever. I like A Boogie is that shit, right? So we're leaving, and I was like, okay, now I definitely need to get a shirt. I saw this dude, he had all these colors on his arm, but I saw this. I said, he got pink. Ran my ass over there. So I was like, how much you want? How much you want? I was like, I don't care. Like, how much you want? So I got this. Shit is so fire. This is so fucking fire. Like, I think I might actually try and put that shit on, like, with this shit. This is so fucking cute. So here's the little close up. It's A Boogie, period. We look good together. But I don't want no smoke, Ella. And then on the back, it got like the tours and everything. I wish I put the set list on there because the set list actually ate. And he left, like his last song was Drowning. Oh my god. It says, she like me, bitch, I'm drowning. And I just wanna keep her ringing. And then it about it. Yo, it was this one girl that was next to me the whole concert. And like the songs that I knew, she didn't know. But like she knew, like, I wrote the song for the last bitch that did me wrong. Like, she knew the old A Boogie. I'm not gonna lie. Like, she knew the SoundCloud A Boogie. I knew, like, 3 of the SoundCloud A Boogie joints. But she's an OG. Like, she knew the old joints. Now, the new shit, she wasn't really fucking with it. Like, she was fucking with DTB and shit. But I give whoever that was a pop. Love you, my heart. And then me and my sister got the same one. And this. I wish I had like good shoes. I don't have no like yellow looking shoes. I need to get a new pair of Sambas or a new pair of Asics. But, well, who am I kidding? I'm getting a new pair of Sambas, but they pink. My sister got this, and she got it because it goes with her. She got the yellow Jordan 4s, so it matches with hers. But I don't have nothing to match this. But this would be cute with like a pair of cargos and my Asics, or y'all know them like 1906 New Balance, like the gray, black, and white ones. That would be cute with these, but I would never just buy a pair of shoes for one outfit because I would never wear the New Balance again. But this is that. That's all I got. And yesterday we went to Wawa. My mom threw out my fucking Wawa, so I don't have that no more. So now I go back into hiding until the next vlog, Atlantic City. So motherfucking excited to have sand in my feet, sun beaming on my ass, like. I can't wait. Like, I literally need, like, I haven't been to the beach in almost a year. July will make a year. But I need it. Like, I just need it. After, like, is turbulence is the word? I guess. All the turbulences I went through, like, with graduation and then prom, too. Like, I just need a beach reset. So I am super excited for that. I literally can start packing like right now because I don't really need much, I literally have everything packed over there. I just need to pack like the skincare and stuff, and that'll be the day of, because I have to be at my friend's house by 3 because we're driving all in one car together. So yeah, the fuck was that? So yeah, that was the A Boogie concert. I'm not really going to another concert. Like, I wanted to go to Chris Brown. By the time I looked at the tickets, that shit was too much money. Like, $2.95 for nosebleeds? And then I wanted to go to Janine a long time ago and Bryson a long time ago, but I just never bought the tickets, so that's kind of on me. But, like, I really wanted to go to Chris Brown. But my sister's going to Chris Brown and Janine, so I'm still getting merch from that shit. I'm sending her my motherfucking money. Bitch, get me some shit. Can't be there physically, so I'm gonna be there mentally. And then after this vlog comes out, we have the AC vlog. I don't know when the AC vlog is gonna be out for real. But then after the AC vlog, I'm gonna see y'all till July for the South Carolina trip. Beach will also be in my feet because, ooh, I can't wait for the South Carolina trip. That's the family reunion. We're leaving July 10th. I don't know when we're coming back. We're supposed to come back the 14th because I start moving the 15th. Or we start moving. Let me stop saying it like that. But I have to start buying stuff for that trip. And then I have to start buying stuff for my room. It's a lot. So subscribe. Make sure that you're updated with everything. I post content on here. Sometimes TikTok. Because on TikTok, y'all really be following me. But that's the end of the A Boogie vlog. Oh!